This is stupid. I'm the dominant of fire. We sent Gav on a wild goose chase.
Perfect little shortcut, Sid. Straight to a nest of bloodthirsty beasts.
That's enough. Sick of Toggle.
Is it, boy?
After him! Don't let him escape! Gav! Who goes there? This one's a deserter! Take his head!
Out of my way!
You made your choice!
You know what to do, boy.
There, boy!
situation.
You're late. Get in trouble.
What?
The Imperials are on his tail. We have to get to him before they do.
Understood. I'm here to even the odds. Any objections?
I'll take the dragon. You take the dragoon.
Get him, boy!
Bastards fly. But what goes up must come down. Bloody time waster. Come on, let's finish him off. Come on.
Shit!
There. Clive doesn't have your nose, I said. He'd stumble off a cliff, I said.
Well, that's the trouble with a nose like mine. Can't help sticking it where it's not wanted. But if it wasn't for you two, my sniffing days would be over. Thank you. Truly.
So, what news?
Well, found out where your friend's heading, for one thing.
Gav, I...
Him and his mate are on their way to your old stomping ground, Rosaria. You should have seen what they did to the Imperials who tried to stop them. There's no question about it. He's a dominant of fire, all right.
He can't be.
Clive, I saw you turn into an icon before my very eyes. And yes, there's a good chance it was you who killed the Phoenix. But we weren't alone, were we? There was the fellow you saw enter the whirlwind. I saw him too. You didn't dream it, Clive. He's out there.
But who is he?
Don't ask me. I don't bloody know. But I do know one thing. You're gonna find him and find out. After all, you swore an oath.
What?
You swore you'd avenge your brother's death. That you'd never rest until you'd hunted down the man responsible. So, find out if this man's responsible and kill yourself if he's not.
Sid, I...
Don't thank me. Thank Gav.
Thank you, Gav.
Yeah, there you are.
No birds returning this year.
The deadlands have swallowed their roosts, like as not. We're running out of time.
We'll be in Rosaria in a day or two.
Back to where it all began. He must be stopped.
Spitting great gouts of fire he was, like a bleeding volcano.
Ever seen a volcano?
What? You think I'm having you on?
Clive! Your friend! She's awake!
Right.
Go to her, you fool. Right, you lot. Enough slacking. Goots, come with me. Gav, go and get those wounds seen to.
Oh, give it to me straight. How long have I got?
So?
All in good time. Let's make ourselves scarce.
Jill.
Isn't the Moogle funny?
Let's get this fixed before someone...
It's true then. It really is you.
It is.
Clive! You're alive.
So are you. I still can't believe it. Are your wounds healed?
Yes. Talia told me what happened. You saved my life.
After nearly taking it, I had no idea. Forgive me, but how did you ever come to be there, Jill? Fighting for them.
The Iron Blood. They invaded not long after the news arrived about Phoenix Gate. Rosaria had lost her leaders. The duchy was in chaos. The Iron Kingdom saw our weakness and pounced upon it. They killed the men and captured the women.
And took you back to Ironhome.
I thought they meant to have their fun with me before the end. But the end never came. My powers awoke, and everything changed. It all happened so fast.
We were told that the Iron Blood had captured a dominant and planned to bring her on their latest crusade.
They gave me a choice. To fight for them on the battlefield, or see my countrywomen slaughtered.
And they call us dominant.
What? What happened, Clive? What happened at Phoenix Gate?
It was me. I killed Joshua.
No, that's not true. I know you. You wouldn't do that.
It's the truth. I changed into him again. Not long ago. The second Icon of Fire. The one responsible.
Clive.
When I think back to that night... The hooded man... He spoke to me. What did he say?
Sarsis.
We have found you. What did he mean?
Clive, we should go back there, to Phoenix Gate. I need to know what really happened, and so do you. You need to know for certain. And if what you told me is true, and you did what you said you did, then we will face it together.
Jill, I... All right.
You'll be needing a change of clothes, then. Out you go, your lordship. We wouldn't want you getting overexcited.
Sorry.
I'll see you soon, then, Clive.
I should be ready too. We've a long journey ahead of us.
We're looking at half a dozen.
You! Newcomer! I need help.
What's the matter?
It's my assistant. She left to gather soil, and I've seen nothing of her since. I cannot concentrate one whit for fear of what might have happened. Please, I beg of you, will you go and check? I have to know.
All right, I'll go.
Marvelous. Thank you. You'll be rewarded for your time, of course.
Whereabouts is she?
Gotan's Bales. It's on the outskirts of Lostwig. Not the safest place for an unaccompanied bearer, perhaps, but the soil there is second to none. Now go, and do not linger. Why, it may already be too late.
Teams to follow every lead.
Oh. Ah, Clive. I trust you're settling in?
Gradually getting used to the place.
I'm glad to hear it. I was hoping you might be persuaded to come to my aid once more. Your services will be rewarded, of course.
I don't doubt it. Seems to be the way around here.
We strive to be better than those we once served. Now, as to the task itself, I am once again in need of a pair of hands to deliver sustenance to our esteemed companions. I have three meals for three industrious souls. What say you?
I'd be happy to help.
Marvelous. The three individuals you'll be seeking out are busying themselves about the hideaway. You'll find one by the entrance, another in the bunks, and the other guarding the cells. Thank you once again, Clive.
Something smells good. For me, I hope.
It is. Courtesy of Kenneth.
Oh, my thanks. These birds are needy creatures. They don't like me running after the fat chocobo behind their backs.
They must keep you busy.
Ah, there's never a moment's rest. Probably for the best I eat down here, reeking of the stables as I do. I'd only put people off their food. And who has time to wash and dress for dinner when they've got little darlings like these to wait upon, eh? Anyway, thanks for the food, and be sure to give Kenneth my regards.
So soon? Fancied another kip in the cells, did you?
Kenneth sent me. He thought you might be hungry.
He wasn't wrong. The way my gut's been growling, I'd have curls running scared.
Guard duty down here can't be much fun.
It's not. But sometimes folk need locking up, and someone has to watch over them. I help people sleep at night, and that's not a boast many can make. You keep yourself on the right side of these bars now, you hear me?
Could really do with a proper place to train.
Oh, what I wouldn't give for some wild Mickey berries.
Can I help you? Kenneth sent me. Ah, wonderful. Do you hear that? Our food has arrived. Does your appetite still elude you? Is he sick? I'm afraid so. Those no longer in need of a physica's immediate ministrations are sent here for further rest. I tend to those who cannot tend to themselves, which leaves me very little time for anything else. Happily, Kenneth sees that I stay fed. I would be lost without the kindness of good people like him and yourself. Thank you. I think that's everyone. I better let Kenneth know.
We're looking at half a dozen, maybe more.
Their bunks are made up.
Isn't the Moogle funny?
Ah, you're back. All done? Wonderful. Here, your reward, as promised.
The hideaway is quite something. Everyone has their place.
A fact we are proud of, believe me. I'm glad you've witnessed it for yourself. You have your place too, of course, as you have just so capably proven, and you will always have a place with us, should you desire it.
It's kind of you to say so.
It is the truth, and not a soul among us would deny it. I look forward to all that you will bring to our little community.
They even have a Moogle. I've never seen one in the flesh. I'm sure it's said in my father's bestiary that they live deep in the forest, and that they never reveal themselves to humans. Nectar, you say? Clive. So it would seem. That sounds painful. Someone's in trouble.
you hurt?
It would have been worse if you hadn't come along. Wait, I've seen you around the hideaway. You're new, aren't you?
I'm Clive.
And I'm Martel. But what are you doing here?
Looking for you. This is no place for a bearer on her own.
I noticed that. But this soil's not going to collect itself.
Then what if I gathered it for you? You could head back to the hideaway. Just exactly what sort of dirt is it that you need?
What I need is soil. But I'd be a fool to refuse your help after what just happened. It's the good stuff you're looking for. Dark, rich, fragrant. You'll know it when you find it.
Dark, rich, and fragrant. Right. Well, you should hurry back. Bohemil seemed worried enough that he might come looking for you himself.
That seems unlikely, but I won't argue with you. Thanks.
Soil, then. There's certainly enough of it here. But is it dark, rich, and fragrant? That should be enough. I better get it back to the hideaway.
There you are. And? All safe and sound?
Well, yes, she's standing right there.
Not the girl. The soil. Did you bring it?
Yes. Here.
Glorious! When Martel came home empty-handed, I almost had a fit. But with this, my research can continue. First and foremost come the measurements. I must know how much ether each sample contains. From there...
Wait, so you were never...
Worried about me? Sorry to disappoint you, but the only thing he worries about is his research.
But that's...
That's all right. It's just how he is. And if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be growing anything in these ruins. It's a small price to pay. Although, you shouldn't have to pay it too. Did he even offer you anything for helping? Ugh. Here. I know it's not much, but it's something, at least. I wish I could offer you some fruit too, but you're not likely to thank me if I do. Still, we'll grow something worth eating one of these days, and when we do, you'll have first pick.
Research can continue apace, and when my fertilizer is complete, the world.
What do you want?
To say farewell. We're leaving.
Good decision. Better that than buried out there in the black. You've got a lot to thank that girl for, you know.
I know. And I will.
Now, what do you really want? We both know you don't come here for conversation. I reckon I can find her by you. Off you go, then. And best of luck.
I should probably say thank you to Gav, too.
And what do you want? Go on, then. You'll not find a better price than that. Finished, are you? Yes? What? Coin purse weighing you down? Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Make it quick. What do you want? Yeah, that should do you. You can thank me later. My best work, but it'll do. Yeah, that should do you. You can thank me later. My best work, but it'll do. Anything else?
So your mind's made up, is it?
We'll be leaving for Rosaria as soon as we're able.
Back down memory lane, eh? Rosaria ain't what she used to be, Clive, and not since the Imperials moved in. First sign of trouble, you make straight for Martha's Rest and ask for the landlady. She's a friend of the cause. Tell her you're with Sid, and she'll help you out.
Understood. Thank you, Gav.
Yeah.
I'd be lost without you.
Yeah, I'm just doing my job. No need to make such a fuss. You take care, all right? Oh, I'm crap at goodbyes. Where's Sid when you need him?
Give him my regards when he gets back.
I will.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Ready, my lady?
Ready. Rosaria. It's been 13 years.
But this breeze, the smell of the grass, it's just as I remember it.
You haven't been back either.
I couldn't. Bran did keep a close watch on each other in the Imperial Army. You'd get beheaded just for knowing a deserter. The only way out was on a mission.
I see.
Mostly I was afraid. Afraid to go back.
I know.
But I'm here now. Thanks to you. We should press on.
That inn at the top of the hill must be Martha's Rest. Gav said the landlady's a friend.
But can we say the same for her patrons?
Imperials don't tend to take well to those with my mark. If anyone asks, I'm a branded soldier, sworn to protect my noble mistress.
They never finished building the bridge then.
After what happened at Phoenix Gate, it didn't seem the highest priority.
Oi! Stop and give me an hand. Give me an hand, could you?
Typical. A bloody bearer. Just when I thought my luck had changed. Still, better a crumb of crystal than an empty hand, I suppose. Though it pains me to use another man's branded. Here, you understand me, don't you? I need your help. These blasted birds must have caught whiff of my cargo, and now they've got me surrounded. It was really late as it was. I've got something special needs delivering before the rest, but I dare not leave my cart untended. You couldn't run it up to Martha's Rest for me, could you? Needs to get there quick, mind.
Fine.
That's the spirit. All right. Here. You hand that to the stable master and no one else. I'm owed a little something for it. If he gives it to you, pass it along to your master by way of thanks. Be off with you then, and don't go taking any detours on the way.
Get him! sick of talking. Get up, boy. Sick of talking. Get up, boy.
Rest.
Over here. Sick of Torgel. Get him, boy. You know what to do, boy. Sick of Torgel. There, boy.
Stable master, I was asked to deliver this to you.
This is for me, right enough. Not sure what some bearer is doing bringing it to me, though. Where's that fool of a peddler got to?
He couldn't come himself. His cart's surrounded by wild chocobos.
Huh. Sounds about right. He'll have it full of Gizal Greens, no doubt. Crammed with them, if I know him.
Gizal Greens?
Chocobos go mad for them, don't they? And if you forget to seal the cart up tight, the smell gets out, and birds come running from miles around. Don't get me wrong. They're a fine investment for a savvy merchant, especially around these parts. But you can't get greedy, as our mutual friend is learning the hard way. Still, I got my wares, and that's all that matters. Be sure to pass your master my regards.